So if you're trying to sell your home and you haven't had much luck, we're here to help you today. There are ways you can make your home more attractive to a potential buyer, but it might make you a little uncomfortable in the process. Here today to explain is real estate expert TJ Larson from My Town Home Realty. TJ, are there things people can do to actually help sell their house that they might not normally do? Explain that to us.
Well, the first thing I'm going to start with is declutter, but I've got to tell you a story. When I got into the business, I was very young, and I started to give sellers advice on how they should sell their house. I'd done that before I ever had actually sold my own home. Mm-hmm. And what I told them is, oh, it's a painless process. I can take all the issues out of it for you. This won't be a problem at all. I'm here to admit on air that it is not a painless process.
Yes, sir.
One of the things you have to do is you have to declutter. Here's my example. If you go into my kitchen right now, I'm a cook, and I love to have everything that I've got spread out all over the countertops. It's all at arm's reach. I don't have to open a drawer or a cabinet to get to anything. Mm-hmm. But if I was going to go to sell my house, it's not show ready. It's cluttered throughout the kitchen. So although it might be inconvenient for me to put all of those things away, the benefit is I can sell the house faster by getting that clutter out of the way.
Okay. What about major repairs? Should you invest the time and money to do some renovations, stuff like that?
Yeah, there's repairs and there's renovations. On the repairs, I would say absolutely. You're going to get caught on your inspection report. I shouldn't say caught, but you're going to get caught on the inspection report anyway, and you're going to have to take care of those things. So if you've got an HVAC system that's out, that's going to get caught on the inspection report. You're going to have to take care of it. Why not do that ahead of time? Mm-hmm. If you've got wood rot, why not do that ahead of time? A door that doesn't work, there you go. As far as renovations are concerned, dollar for dollar, it's very difficult to get your money back out of renovations. Now, if you're a general contractor, if you can do some sweat equity on the home, you might be able to pull some equity out that way. But for most of us that are going to hire a contractor, very difficult to get a renovation project that's actually going to pay off. I would recommend doing small, low-cost projects. Replace carpet or steam clean carpet. Certainly deep clean the home. Repaint some rooms, get some better colors, freshen up the paint. Those are the type of things that I think will pay you back.
Things that people are going to really see, the visual part about it. What about the outside of your home? What should you do with that? I mean, landscaping, things like that?
Absolutely. I mean, curb appeal is extremely important. Let's think about the first two ways that somebody probably tries to find a home. You've got the folks that are going to drive around on Sunday, and they're going to look at the exterior. They're going to eliminate a lot of homes because the curb appeal is not there. The other area is over 80% of the people are looking at homes on the internet, and what's that first photo that comes up? It's a primary. It's an exterior photo of the home. You need to get them inside the home in order to have any chance at selling it. So what can you do on the outside? First of all, your lawn. Let's spruce the lawn up as much as possible. Pull the weeds, edge the lawn. You've got some dead patches, come in and fix that. You may need to resod the lawn. Okay. Pine needles, extremely inexpensive way that you can spruce up the curb appeal on a home.
And then what about leaving? Should you get out of the home when they're coming?
Absolutely, get out of the house. Okay. Don't micromanage the process. You know, their realtor's going to be there. Your realtor might be there. You don't need to be in the house while they're showing. And the thing is, you want them to have open and honest commentary about the house. They can't do that in front of you if you're the homeowner. And if you're there and they can't get out that open and honest commentary, then it's going to fester. They're not going to be able to move on to the positive aspects of the home. And I've had this happen 1,000 times. Yeah. Homeowner was there. Soon as we get into the car, they start saying, okay, did you see those countertops? Let's get that off your chest, move on, and we can sell that house.
Great advice. Great advice. You can visit TJ's website at mytownhome.com, where you can get all the information that you would possibly need.